Hello everyone, welcome to another video. This is me, your host Prajwal, and today we're going to talk about zKSync and how you can be eligible for a potential airdrop that might happen in the future. So let's get started. Quick disclaimer, none of the things mentioned in this video is or should be taken as a financial advice. The sole purpose of this video is to provide you any information on research that I've done or that I've found online. And as always, please make sure you give this video a thumbs up. If this was helpful, please leave any comments, any questions in the comment section below, and subscribe and hit the bell icon if you'd like to be notified every time I put out another video or a guide in the future. If you are familiar with these roll-ups or layer 2 scaling solutions built solely for Ethereum, like Optimism and Arbitrum. Another one is called zKSync, which has been around for a while now, but is gaining a popularity recently because they are moving towards their mainnet possibly very soon in the future. Now, why do we think that this might have an airdrop? Is because initially on their Medium blog, there was a mention of a token or a governance token that might be given to the community in the future. That has been since removed. And this was pointed out by Chico Crypto. I just want to make sure that you understand that this is not my finding, but this was discovered by Chico Crypto. But since then, that has been removed. And on October 13th, Unisync, a port of Uniswap V2, has been launched on the zk EVM. What it basically means is they've got a sort of a testnet that looks like Uniswap, but that actually runs on zk EVM, and people can go and test out this platform for free. So you don't have to put any funds, and everyone believes that anyone who uses this platform or uses the testnet will be eligible for a potential airdrop. Another thing is, if you scroll down to the bottom of the Medium article, you'll see that it says, PS, we have some very exciting news coming soon. Stay up to date. So this can mean anything, right? But by looking at what they had on the Medium blog, that there will be a token and that will be provided to the community, which basically sounds like an airdrop. So that has been since removed, but this article came out on October 13th asking people to try the port of Uniswap V2 on zk EVM, which is the zk Ethereum virtual machine. And I'll show you the steps that I've taken, which I think should be enough or make you eligible for an airdrop that might happen in the future. I suggest you do this from a PC, your laptop, your desktop, whatever, not from your phone. It can be done from a phone as well, but it's quite complicated. But on a desktop PC or desktop browser, it's quite straightforward and it only takes a couple of minutes. All right, so I'm going to show you from the start. If you've never used MetaMask, this is how you set up MetaMask. And if you have set up MetaMask before, you can skip this part and go to the part where I show you how to claim the funds and do the transaction on the testnet. If you have never used or if you've never set up a MetaMask, this is the process to do it. All right, so for the purpose of this video, I'm going to use Firefox browser, but you can basically use any browser you prefer. For example, you can use Edge, you can use Google Chrome, you can use Brave browser. It's up to you. And once you go to metamask.io, be careful on the links that you visit, all right? Because there's a lot of scams and there's a lot of wannabe websites out there. So you don't want to download the wrong thing. So go to metamask.io, verify the link, click on download now, choose where you're going to download that. So by default, it will detect you the browser you're trying to download MetaMask from. For me, it's showing me Firefox. I click on install MetaMask for Firefox, but Google Chrome, Firefox, Brave, and Edge as well. So you got to make sure that's a new Edge, not the old Edge. Click on install MetaMask for Firefox. It will take you to the extensions. Click on add to Firefox. And the process is exactly the same on Google Chrome, by the way. All right. Click on add. And that's added. And now it's taken me to the welcome page for MetaMask. Click on get started. Click on create a wallet, since we are creating a new wallet. I believe that if you already have a wallet, you'd probably skip to the section where you will be doing the step necessary for the airdrop. Click on create a wallet. I agree. Create a strong password. I have read and agreed to the terms of use. Click on create. You can watch the video if you like to secure your wallet. I'm just going to skip that for now. Click on next. And this is a really important step, because if you lose your recovery phrase, you will lose access to your account. For example, you'll have access as long as that wallet is set up in any browser or on any PC. But if you have to reset that, or if you lose access to those computers or devices that has that wallet, for you to be able to import or for you to be able to regain access to that wallet, you need this phrase. So always make sure you have backup, double backup of this phrase. Click on reveal the secret words and create a backup. Once you have that ready, click on next. And now you gotta click on these words and make sure they are in the same pattern or in the same order that it was before, right? So once that's done, click on confirm. And it says congratulations, click on all done, and your account is ready, right? So if you have the wallet already, you're all good to go. Once again, there's no guaranteed, but these couple of steps should make you eligible for the airdrop that might happen in the future. The first thing is you've got to try out UniSync. So if you go to the page medium.com, I'll leave the link in the description for the Medium article if you want to read in detail what this is about and what are they launching and what the stuff is about. So you go to launch dApp, so it's basically uni.zksync.io. And once you go there, it says, hello, ZK EVM. We ported Uniswap VDCon smart contracts and front end to the first ever fully functional ZK EVM test. And don't have to worry about that. If you don't understand, just click on launch app. This looks almost exactly like Uniswap. It is because they've used the similar interface for this testnet. What you got to do is click on connect wallet, click on MetaMask, click on next, connect. Right, it will say that it's a wrong network. Now you can manually enter them, or your wallet would automatically load the information for the network. Click on approve, click on switch network, and the first part is done. Second part is you need to request tokens from faucet. So this is basically you are asking for test money from them to do the swaps and everything. So that's why you don't need any funds in your wallet. So click on request tokens. Click on tweet. You do need to have a Twitter account though. So if you don't have one, you'll have to create one. If you would like to test out the platform, click on tweet. Once you've tweeted, you'll see a window that you have successfully claimed. Click on OK and you'll get 300 USDC. Please remember that this is not real funds or real assets that you have. It's just a test funds for you to use on this testnet. What I suggest is just do a couple of swaps. So you can swap it to Chainlink, for example. 150, allow Uniswap protocol. As you can see, it says you allow the Uniswap protocol. Click on allow, just sign that, and that's approved. As you can see, it was very instant. And swap, confirm the swap. So this is like play money, so you don't have to worry about any funds getting deducted and stuff like that. And it says congratulations, you just made your first swap with zkSync 2.0. keep up to date Twitter or join the testnet. So this testnet is for any projects or any companies that would like to test out their testnet. That's fine, click on close. What I would do is I would go and swap that link back to USDC. Just everyone is, this is just a guessing game at this point, right? So if you remember, Uni did a airdrop for its holders before. If you had any swaps done, or if you had interacted with Uniswap before September 2020, you would get a airdrop for 400 UNI tokens, and it was a fair airdrop, meaning if there was one transaction for you from your account, you would get 400 UNI tokens. So now no one knows. Similar airdrop was done by 1inch as well. So if you had done a couple of transactions, not one, but two transactions, you were able to claim the airdrop from 1inch. So for that purpose, I just do a couple of swaps just in case. And since it's free money, so I'll do that swap, confirm, sign that again, and success. Right, it says transaction fee. That's fine. First thing, right, everyone says, if you watch other videos, people will say that this is enough for you to claim an airdrop if that happens. So, but there's another thing that I like to do, or I have done. So if you go to zkSync's homepage, you will see there's an option to open wallet. So basically you can bridge your Ethereum from layer one Ethereum to layer two, which is zkSync. There's no dApps or there's no any applications or protocols that you can try using it. But still, a small amount of money I've transferred from layer one to layer two, just in case that is also a criteria that you need to fulfill for airdrop, right? Click on open wallet. So once you are in wallet.zksync.io, it will say connect to your L1 ETH wallet to start. Before you do that, what I suggest is if you are still on the testnet, you got to go and change it to Ethereum mainnet. Well, it will give you the prompt anyways, but just in case, go there, click on Ethereum wallet, click on MetaMask. And as you can see, it says balances in L2. There's no balances yet, right? So L2 meaning you haven't bridged or you haven't transferred any funds from layer 2 to layer 1. So zKSync being the layer 2. And layer 1 is your just normal MetaMask that is on Ethereum layer 1 chain. So you need to have some Ethereum first. But I've seen that the transfer fees are fairly lower as compared to Optimism and also Arbitrum. Right, so as you can see, I have around $300. Out of that, I'll probably transfer only $20 or $25 since you cannot do anything after you bridged, right, at the moment. All right, so I'm going to click on deposit from L1 and select my main accounts, collect token, Ethereum. I'm going to transfer 0.0052, which is worth roughly $20. Click on deposit from L1. And as you can see, it's showing me $20 gas fees, right? So I'll say confirm. And as you can see, the deposit has been confirmed. Click on OK. And once the transaction is completed, as you can see, it's showing me nothing, but it will show up here, right? So that's basically it. If you want to withdraw, there will be a withdraw option as well on the window once the transfer is completed. But I believe these couple of things should be sufficient for making you eligible for the airdrop if that happens in the future. Again, not a financial advice and not a guarantee that there will be one, but if there is supposed to be one, I think these couple of processes should be more than enough, right? If you have more information, if you think I've missed something, please make sure you reach out to me in the comments below. If you have any other projects that you are interested in or want me to have a look, please leave them in the comments as well. Please like the video if this was helpful, subscribe for more, and you have a nice day. Thank you.